Hello friends, today I am going to discuss about precision. In my previous video I have already discussed about accuracy, so you can watch that video also, link is given here. Now coming to the precision, so literal meaning of precision is that it is the repeatability of the values. So when we will determine same quantity and when we will get the same values, that will be known as precise values. Now coming to the definition of precision. So precision is defined as degree of agreement between the replicate measurement of the same quantity. So when we will measure same quantity by using same method, then we will get the replicate result. If we will get the replicate result, so that result is known as precise. And this precision is measured in the terms of standard deviation. Means if value of standard deviation is less, then that particular measurement is precise. If value of standard deviation is high, then that particular value or that particular measurement is known as less precise or non-precise. So I will discuss the calculation of standard deviation in later part. So first I will discuss the illustration of this precision by using suitable diagrammatic representation. So first I will draw some circles for better understanding of this precision. So these are the three targets. If anyone is hitting this black circle, then he will get 10 points. If anyone is hitting this red circle, then he will get 9 points. If anyone is hitting this green circle, then he will get 8 points. If anyone is hitting this blue circle, then he will get 7 points. For example, if we are having three persons A, B and C and they will hit these circles, then we will compare the precision of those particular persons. So person A will hit like this, person B will hit like this and person C will hit like this. So person A will get 3 points, that will be 10 plus 10 plus 10. And the person B will get another 3 points, that will be 9 plus 8 plus 7. And the person C will also get 3 points, that will be 8 plus 8 plus 8. Now coming to the precision of this person A. So here you can see that there is a replication in the values, that is 10, 10 and 10. So here standard deviation value will come 0. Now if we are talking about this B, then it is 9 plus 8 plus 7. So if we will calculate the standard deviation for person B, so it will be more than 0. If we are talking about person C, then also here it is 8 plus 8 plus 8, means there is replication in the values. So standard deviation for this person C will also be 0. So there is a same precision occur for person A and a person C. But if we are talking about the accuracy, so person A is more accurate, because here if we are taking the highest number as a standard, so it will be 30. So A is near to the 30, means it is exactly 30, but C is not near to the 30. So in that case, person A will be more accurate and person C will be less accurate as compared to A. Okay. But if we are talking about precision, then person A and C both are equally precise. Now here I am taking one example for better understanding of this precision. So question is that two analysts done the analysis and the standard value is 100 and their observations are for analyst A it is 97, 96, 99 and 96. And for analyst B, it is 92, 91, 93 and 92. And the question is that who has done more precise analysis? So solution for this question will be like this. So first we will take the formula for standard deviation. So there are mainly two formula for standard deviation. One is for a sample and one is for population. And those formula will be like this. So these are the two formula which can be used for determination of standard deviation. First one is for sample, that is s is equal to under root summation x minus x bar square divided by n minus 1. And this formula is for determination of standard deviation for population. So sigma is equal to under root summation x minus mu square divided by n. Now what is difference between sample and population? So if we are taking a example of class, if in a class total 50 students are there and if we want to determine the average weight of those 50 students, if we are taking 10 students as a sample and we are determining the average weight of those 10 students only, so that will be known as sample and we will determine standard deviation by this formula for those sample. But if we are taking the average weight of all those 50 students, so that case is known as population. And for determination of standard deviation of those population will be determined by using this formula. Okay, so in analysis generally we are using this formula because in analysis generally we are taking only samples. So by using this formula we can solve this question. So first we have to determine x bar. What is x bar? X bar is the mean or average of these values. So x bar value for analyst A and analyst B will be like this. So 97 plus 96 plus 99 plus 96 divided by 4. So it will be 388 divided by 4 and it will be 97. Now coming to the analyst, so it will be like this. So here 92 plus 91 plus 93 plus 92 divided by 4. So it will be 368 divided by 4. So it will be 92. Now coming to the x minus x bar. So first we will write the value of x for analyst A. So x is equal to 97, 96, 99 and 96. Now coming to this value x minus x bar. X minus x bar. So value of x is 97, 96, 99 and 96 and the value of x bar is 97. So 97 minus 97 it will be 0, 96 minus 97 it will be minus 1, 99 minus 97 it will be plus 2 and 96 minus 97 it will be minus 1. Now coming to this value, that is x minus x bar square, x minus x bar square. So we will square this one, so 0 square will be 0. Minus 1 into minus 1 will be 1, plus 2 into plus 2 will be 4 and minus 1 into minus 1 will be 1. So value for summation x minus x bar square is equal to 4 plus 1 plus 1. So it will be 6. Now coming to the analyst B. So it will be like this. Value of x is 92, 91, 93 and 92. Now coming to the x minus x bar square. So 92 minus 92, so it will be 0. 91 minus 92, it will be minus 1. 93 minus 92, it will be plus 1. 92 minus 92, it will be 0. Now coming to the x minus x bar square. So 0 square will be 0. Minus 1 square will be plus 1. Plus 1 square will be again plus 1. And 0 square will be 0. Now value for summation x minus x bar square is equal to 0 plus 1 plus 1 plus 0, it will be 2. Now we will put these two values 6 and 2 in this formula. So it will be like this. Why here I am taking 4? Because here we have taken 4 observations. 1, 2, 3, 4. So it will be under root 6 divided by 4 minus 1. So it will be 3. So under root 6 divided by 3 will be under root 2, and the value for under root 2 is 1.414. Now coming to the analysis B. So it will be S is equal to under root 2 divided by 4 minus 1. So it will be under root 2 divided by 3. So it will be under root 0.667. And when we will solve this root, then it will be 0.816. So here you can see that standard deviation value for analyst A is 1.414 and for analyst B it is 0.816. So if any analyst is having less standard deviation value, that is more precise. So here in this question, analyst B has done the more precise analysis. So this is the details about precision, and by using this formula you can compare the precision value of different observations. Thank you.